40 by now. RK Davis is backcourt making nearly half his shots from distance this year. Chance for a three-point play for the USC transfer from Norcross, Georgia, Kyle Sturdivant.
Tough bucket by Kyle Sturdivant, getting to the body of Armando Bacot and finishing through the contact. And Doug, this is something that I've seen, and I wanted to bring it to your attention. Okay. I've seen it throughout college basketball so much. Have you ever noticed that the guy that makes the shot is always the one yelling, "Let's go"? Kyle Sturdivant just did it on the ground to his teammates, "Let's go." How many guys do you see say "Let's go" when they weren't the one that made the shot? Do you see that often?
I guess I never thought about it.
But being a leader is great. But if you're going to lead your team, it doesn't necessarily have to be when you've been successful. It's when the team has been successful. And Kevin Love is leading his team being successful. He's not telling anyone, "Let's go." They're following his example, getting to the rim, getting it done on both ends of the floor. And nothing against Kyle Sturdivant. He's not the only one. I saw Joe Girard do it yesterday. He comes down, he knocks down a three, he's yelling, "Let's go." Yell "Let's go" when Buddy Boeheim knocked down a three. That's when you're really going to win.
The things you think about on those long flights.
Man, that's it. You know, too much travel time in this job.
By the way, I wanted to mention to you, I was in your neck of the woods yesterday for an FCS playoff football game. We got a home ball call.
Were you at James Madison?
I was at James Madison, and I was on the service elevator at their football stadium. Someone asked me where I was going to be today, and I said I got a basketball game before Corey Alexander. And the woman who was running the elevator, the attendant, immediately says, "Oh, Waynesboro, Virginia." I'm like, I can't get away from this guy.
I have an honorary degree from James Madison University. From the age of 14 to 17, I spent more time there than I did in Waynesboro. My big cousin, Kenny Brooks, was playing basketball at JMU at the time. And, of course, I was always there. So I'm honorary Duke at James Madison as well. And right there, North Carolina.
Yeah, they still remember you.
You got her the perfect gift. Does it matter if you give her the perfect battery?
Have you seen things that you think are sustainable for Coach Davis's club going forward?
I do believe they're sustainable, and I believe the loss.
Yo, what's up, everybody? I finally found this game. I was going to do some commentating on it, but I am not going to commentate. I'm going to close my mouth, and I'm going to let you guys listen to it and watch the screen. And thank you guys for showing up. I appreciate it.
It went back to the same old defensive principles for North Carolina. Guys weren't keeping their men in front of them against Brown, scored 90-plus points, and they started giving up points after points. Teams were averaging over 80 against North Carolina in those next few games. So then when you consider to taking the losses to Purdue, where they gave up 94 points, and then taking the loss to Tennessee, both of those where both teams shot 55% against North Carolina, I believe Hubert Davis was able to get the team's ear and get them to understand we cannot be successful playing defense the way that they are. They came back and they had two strong performances defensively afterwards, and another one here this afternoon.
Now the Tar Heels come in at 5-2 today, same as Georgia Tech. The Yellow Jackets had their five-game winning streak snapped on Wednesday in the Big Ten ACC Challenge loss to Wisconsin. Tar Heels, meanwhile, with that impressive win over the Wolverines, winning big, and their defense has been so much better.
Right now, the officials are having conversation regarding the possession arrow and who the basketball belongs to. did read Hubert Davis's lips saying it's our ball, correct? And right now you see Jeffrey Anderson, Tony Henderson having a conversation regarding Josh Bassett. At this point, everyone thinks it's their basketball. But Hubert Davis actually was correct on this one. The basketball will go to North Carolina.
And Jeffrey Anderson, a Final Four official.
A great crew we have on this game tonight. And the thing I love most about this group, officials that you can talk to. That was always my thing as a player. I always wanted to have officials that I could have a conversation with during the game. They were willing to have to talk.
Down to three on the shot clock. Caleb Love draws contact, no call. Brady Manning sticks it back in.
But although Caleb Love doesn't get a bucket on that one, the difference between him hoisting up a three with a long rebound in comparison to attacking the basket and putting it on the rim softly allows Brady Manning to be able to get the second chance points and the tip in. A long three miss leads to long rebounds, but a soft attempt off the rim allows Brady Manning to be able to gather that mid-air, lay it back in, second chance points, and increase the lead to 15 for North Carolina, who now has 36 points in the bank.
And Corey, I don't know if you saw it in The Athletic a couple of weeks ago, but it was very interesting where they interviewed, I don't know, dozens of Division I college basketball coaches, and they were allowed to answer anonymously about officials, so you heard both the good and the bad. Takeover, here comes Caleb Love. Was blocked from behind by Khalid Moore. But one of the recurring themes from the officials' survey, talking to the coaches, is that the ones who surveyed better were the ones who, as you say, were willing to have conversation and willing also to acknowledge that I might have missed that one.
Yeah, well, they missed that one. That's a foul. Okay. Love, hit on the arm. And again, you know, that's fair. When you're a basketball player, you're on the court, one thing's for certain is you recognize that the hardest job in the game is not shooting the three in the corner by Brady Manning. He does that easily. It's not being on the court. It's being an official. This is the hardest part of the game. When you look at basketball, there's always going to be someone who disagrees with the officials. It can be plain as day that they got it right, but there's always going to be someone that disagrees. And so when you're, as an official, you have the personality, you're personal enough to have a conversation with the players, with the coaches. Of course, that is going to bring you back to a human level and always going to allow you to have a better relationship.
Sturdivant, pull up. And the officials again in this ballgame, Ted Valentine, Jeff Anderson, Tony Henderson. And they have done an outstanding job. Under 4 minutes remaining in regulation as the Tar Heels have pulled away in the second half. We were tied at the intermission. Baycott coughs it up. Clean look. Depot getting three more.
And Georgia Tech trying to make a run the same way they did in the first half with Depot knocking down threes. But Georgia Tech turning defense into offense. Turnovers turning into points on the other end of the floor. Allowing the Rambling Wreck to cut this lead back to 13.
Here's R.J. Davis. Little hesitation. Top floater. Good.
But when you have two guards like North Carolina does, R.J. Davis and Caleb Love, both with the ability to attack you offensively and find their teammates, it makes it extremely difficult to defend.
So Davis becomes the sixth Tar Heel to score 20 or more points in a game so far this season. And good balance for the Heels. Four in double figures. Love 15, Baycott 15, Manic 12. Davis leading the way with 21 points.
Our house seemed like a dream come true. Great character, great neighborhood.
Until Mrs. Cashman started feeding the neighborhood cats.
There's a timeout on the floor. Carolina in control of this one right now with 3 minutes and 3 seconds left, 72-57. Georgia Tech did make a run early, but Carolina came back strong. Would not say the game is completely over with. Carolina keep playing defense the way they are and scoring the way they are, they should take this one. But again, you got to play into the whistle, play into that horn blows. By the way, we have a timeout on the floor, and here's your full box scores. High score for Carolina is RJ Davis with 21. Then you have Love and Baycott with 15 points apiece, and Manic with 12. For Georgia Tech, we have DeVoe and Coleman with 13, and Moore has 10.
Did you see the one?
Here are the team stats. Carolina is 9 of 16 from the three-point line for 56.3%, and Georgia Tech is 6 of 14 for 42. Both teams shooting pretty good ball from the three-point line when they get a chance. Free throws, Georgia Tech is 100% from the free throw line, 3 of 3. Carolina's 5 of 6 for 83.3. Rebounds, Carolina is actually winning in that area. Assists, Carolina. Turnovers, Carolina has more turnovers, 14 to 13, and somehow they are still in the lead. Imagine how much better or bigger the score might be if they were taking care of the ball today.
Sherman. Hubert Davis' Tar Heels have been able to fend off a Georgia Tech team that's made its last six shots from the floor. But Corey, during that time, they've only shaved 3 points off the deficit. And the Tar Heels just keep shooting it. Here in the second half, collectively, they are 5 of 8. And so Tech just can't make a push.
Well, outside of the first half of this game, North Carolina defensively has been spectacular. You go back to the previous four halves, they've held their opponents under 37% from the field. And they have been very good defensively in this half as well. The first half for this one, Michael DeVoe and the Ramblin' Wreck were able to find some threes and get an offensive rhythm going, but there's been none of that here to the second half of this game.
And the nation's leading scorer, Michael DeVoe, held to 13 points so far, just about half the season average of 25. Tough drive, missed the layup. Sturdivant. Straight line drive, layup missed. But Moore was fouled.
Khalid Moore not settling for the three. Armando Baycott getting a part of the arm. And Caleb Love right now is thinking, where was that call when I was going to the basket for the dunk earlier?
Well, tonight over on the ACC Network, the Huddle Crew will have a College Football Selection Day special, a one-hour show that will include breakdowns and analysis of the ACC's bowl-bound teams and their matchups. Coverage starts at 8 Eastern on ACCN and the ESPN app. Don't have ACCN? Go to get ACCN.com for instant access. Davis fouled on the drive with 2:06 remaining as the Tar Heels try to keep Georgia Tech from cutting further into this lead.
And Doug, what we're seeing, and we talked about the difference between being a freshman guard and a sophomore guard, the maturation between R.J. Davis and Caleb Love. Last year, at this point in the game, both these guys would have settled for threes. They would have settled for jump shots. But now they put so much pressure on the defense trying to attack the basket. to make a play for themselves, the teammates will get to the free throw line.
There's a good look at RJ Davis. And collectively, Davis and Love are taking care of the basketball so far in this one. They've combined for 9 assists, 4 turnovers, which has been a recurring theme we've been talking about all afternoon, Corey.
And their efficiency offensively is completely different than we saw a year ago. Both these guys were shooting in the 20s percentile last year, and now you're talking about 40% plus scores, not only from inside the arc, but shooting in the high 30s from beyond the three-point arc as well. But you mentioned handling the basketball, a 2-to-1 assist turnover ratio combined between the two guys who are going to handle the basketball the most, and both very good free throw shooters, which makes you hard to beat in close games.
No doubt, both shooting the basketball from the floor so much better this year really is something. As it just continues, Love gets to the basket for 2 more.
But Doug, that would have been a play last year where Caleb Love would have went step back, shot at 3. Now he is intelligent enough to know he's grown as a basketball player. There's nothing Georgia Tech can do to stop me from getting to the rim. He does just so and builds this lead to 16 for the Heat.
Quick timeout on the floor, but they are actually right back still in the timeout after the media timeout. If you didn't get a chance to answer the poll question, go answer that. It's almost at 50%. I think the question was, will Carolina score 80 points tonight? And I think it's about 53%. It's 53% yes, 47% no. And as you can see right now, the score is 76-60 with 1:30 left on the clock.
On 12 shots. So you got to give credit to North Carolina's defense. And Anthony Harris, Leaky Black, there have been a number of guys getting involved in that. But Hubert Davis said it's going to take a team effort defensively to slow down a guy like Michael DeVoe. They've done that here, especially in the second half.
Inside out, look at it. For 3, Manico clears the rebound. Just over 1 minute remaining.
1 minute.
Lots of Carolina fans at McCamish Pavilion. You can hear the chants of Let's Go Tar Heels. And Manic responds. He's got 15 points. 4 different heels with 15 or more today.
And North Carolina is so dangerous because you've got 5 to 6 guys who can go out and put up 20 points. So when you think about it, not everyone has to be on the same night. If you get 3 or 4 of those guys on, they're going to be extremely difficult to beat.
Right. It's been a quiet ball game for Dawson Garcia, for Kerwin Walton, and yet still they're about to put up 80 points. And again, the folks in the stands wearing Carolina blue come to their feet. And the Tar Heels are closing out an impressive victory over Tech. That'll do it. 79-62. Hubert Davis's club improves to 6-2 overall now, 1-0 in ACC play.
This is a big win for North Carolina.
Well, that's it today. Carolina did not quite get 80 points, but they got 79 points. Score 79-62. Like I said earlier, on in the game, Georgia Tech did make a run. I think they were up by 13 at one point. And Carolina came back out at halftime and got the lead and never looked back.
Carolina continues to trend in the right direction, led by their sophomore guard from White Plains, New York, R.J. Davis, one of four in double figures, 23 points.
Garcia had 2 points. I'm not sure if Garcia was hurt. Didn't see him in there at the end of the game.
15 points and 13 rebounds.
Bacot, 15 points with 13 rebounds. RJ Davis, 23 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists. Love, 17 points, 6 rebounds. Leaky Black had 5 points today. Wow. Leaky Black had 5 points with 2 rebounds.
What's Manic, better than giving a better points. Phone this holiday season? It's giving a better phone on a better network.
Manic had 15 points with 5 rebounds, 4 assists. And also off the bench, Harris had 2 points. For Georgia Tech, K. Moore, 13 points, 3 rebounds. Howard did not score. He did have 2 rebounds. Usher, 8 points with 3 rebounds. Sturdivant had 11 points, 3 rebounds. DeVoe had 13 points, probably their most valuable player. 13 points, 4 rebounds. Coleman off the bench had 13 points, 1 rebound. And Smith, 4 points with 2 rebounds and 4 assists. And that was it, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks, everyone that showed up. Let's see, the poll ended up being 56% felt like Carolina might score 80, and then 44% no. Didn't quite reach it, but still, that's a nice number of points to score in a college basketball game. Well, guys, I'm getting ready to get out of here. But I will be back in about an hour. If you guys like to check the next game out, I will be streaming the Charlotte Hornets versus the Hawks game. That's a rivalry game for the Hornets. And Hornets actually need to get a win, get back into the winning column. I think they are number 8 right now in the East. So if you guys want to join for that, be my guest. And I will see you guys next time.
Mystery apartment girl.
She feels a breeze
coming from behind the medicine cabinet, so she looks.